हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज अनुपम जैन टीजीटी इंग्लिश फ्रॉम केवी नंबर 1 सागर। माय टॉपिक इज नोटिस राइटिंग। इन दिस पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक आई विल गिव यू आइडियाज अबाउट हाउ टू राइट नोटिस। What are the key points for writing a good notice? How to get good marks while you are writing any notice? You might have studied about it in previous classes also, but I hope it will give you something. So let's start it. Whenever I am teaching notice to my students, generally they are asking a question, Sir, what is a notice? Why do we need to write a notice? Where are these generally useful? So here I am going to give you the answer of question number 1, that is, what is a notice? Actually, notice is a written or printed piece of information passed to a specific group, people or community. So here we have to pay attention towards two things. Number 1, it is a written or printed piece of information. And second thing is that it is passed to a specific group, people or community. Whenever any printed or written piece of information is passed to a specific group of people, that is a type of notice, that is called out notice. Next question is coming into the mind of students or you people. Where do we use it? What are the uses of notice writing? So here is the answer of this question. It is useful for many things, or it is useful for many places. Out of them, first one, in any institute like school, colleges, universities, etc. Second thing, any public office, maybe hospitals, maybe post office, maybe police station, or maybe any other public office which is dealing to the public. Third one, for specific areas like in colonies, buildings. Nowadays, notices of coronavirus are being pasted on different type of buildings. Okay, so notice can be useful for this specific areas also, or specific purpose also. So mainly these are the three uses of notice writing, or where we can use notice writing. Next is, what type of notices are there? This thing is also coming in the mind of students. So, notices may be for, I am going to give you most probable ideas or most probable things where we are generally writing the notice in a student's life. Out of them, first one is lost. Whenever we are losing anything, maybe water bottle, maybe any other thing, in our school premises. So in that condition, we can write a notice for losing that thing. In the same manner, found, a notice can be written whenever you are finding anything and you want to give it back to the owner, then you can frame the notice. But remember, while we are writing these two, lost and found, these are generally personal notices. These are not written by any head of the institute. Next is notice based on any event. Like in our schools, so many events take place during the whole session, like any match, house competition, etc. Notice can be of celebration also. Suppose we are celebrating any program in a school premises, so that notice can be written well and pasted on the notice board. Notice can be written for any novel cause also. Novel causes like flood donation, collecting anything for poor and needy people. As a general notices can be written, and notice related with any announcement, like when we are going to close the school, when it is going to be opened, like that. So these are the most probable type of notices that can come in your examination. While you are writing any type of notice, you have to keep these following key points in your mind. If you are keeping these key points in your mind, your notice can be very good and you can get good marks out of them. First one is that keep the length very precise. While you are writing any type of notice, you have to keep the word limit of 50 words only. Only 50 words are allowed to write any notice. So be very much precise while you are writing any type of notice. So this one first, relevance. For what you are going to write the notice, that relevance should be clearly mentioned in that notice. Sometimes students are going away from the relevance. Next one is formatting. Formatting is the most important part of notice writing, as it is also having marks on it. So while you are writing any notice, be aware of the proper formatting. Later on I will tell you how to follow the formatting. Language, it should be informal only. Next one is very much important. Never use personal pronoun like I or we. Generally we are avoiding use of I or we. But in case of writing notice of lost and found, we are using it, as these notices are based on personal informs. Next one is use of box. While you are writing a notice, you should write under the box. That box must be rectangular in shape. And while you are making rectangular shape, you can make three sides of that box: left side, right side, and top side. You can leave the bottom side for later. Why this? Because sometimes we are writing notice and we are going beyond the limit of that box, and this may be the reason of cutting and any other thing. So it's better to write or make three sides of the rectangular shape, and when you have completed your notice in all respect, you can close the bottom line also. Another one is important point is that use a fresh face whenever you are going to write your answer during examination. Take a fresh face of the answer sheet and try to complete that notice in a single page only, so the checker will not be irritated and you will get surely good marks. And it is very nice also when all the things are available on single page. So if you are keeping these things in your mind, you can be able to write a good notice. Next thing is that be attentive towards 6WH word. While you are writing notice, you have to be attentive towards 6WH words, which are very much important for writing any notice. First one is what. For what you are going to write notice, what purpose is that? That should be clearly understood by you. Next is who. Who is going to write that notice? That you have to take the point from the question itself. Where? Suppose you are writing any notice for any event, then place should be mentioned in that notice very clearly, where that event is going to take place. Otherwise, the reader will not be able to reach at the proper place. Next one is when, means timing. When that event is going to take place, that is also clearly mentioned in the notice, so that the reader will be able to understand everything in one reading. Next is what to do. If you want something from the reader, like participation, names, any material, that should be clearly mentioned while you are writing any notice. Suppose you want to take names of the participants, to whom they will give their names, that is very much important. Next one is whom. Suppose that participant want to take part in that event and give his or her name, to whom he will search, that should also be mentioned into the notice. Then your notice will be nice one or completed one. So remember these six keywords: what, who, where, when, what to do, and whom. Next one is, I am going to deal with layout, how to write any notice. First of all, as I already told you, make a box of three sides. This bottom sides you can make later. So you can design three sides, first, second and third. Then start writing notice. In the middle of the box, write down name of the school or institute. Generally, school's names are asked and that school's name is given into the question itself. If it is not given, you are free to write your own school name. Then, notice, see the notice word, N-O-T-I-C-E, it must be written in capital letters. Then come to the left margin, next line, and write date. Then leave that line on which date is written and come to the next line in middle and write heading. That heading must be catchy. Then from the left margin, start the body. And here is the example of writing body of the notice, from which you can start any type of notice. I have given you two types of starting. First one is that this is to inform to all the students that. You can use this one. If you like another one, you can use this one. All the students are hereby informed that. Then you can start your notice or complete the notice. You can use any other appropriate language if you are having by your own. Then while you are going to close it, don't forget to write S, N and D. S, where is S stands for signature, N stands for name, and D stands for designation. Designation means sometime it is written in the question, you are cultural secretary, you are vice captain, you are head boy, head girl. Like these, all things are related with designation. Now, first example of lost notice. I want to suggest you one thing here, dear student. While you are going to write any notice and start reading the question, keep the pencil with you and try to underline the words which are important in that question. Just recall the memory and go for the earlier one. I have told you, remember 6 WH word, what, who and other four. So just try to keep these WH word in your mind and try to get answer from that question. Here is the example. Suppose I am going to read this question. You are Niket Nikita, a student of Gandhi Vidyalaya Rewa. Write a notice for your school notice board, as you have lost your water bottle in school premises. Promise a reward for a finder. While you are reading, you can underline few things like Niket and Nikita. These are the two names given as an optional. You can use Niket, you can use Nikita. Next one is institute name is here, Gandhi Vidyalaya Rewa. What to do? You have to write a notice for a school notice board, as you have lost your water bottle. And last, what you have to mention? Promise a reward to the finder. So these four or five things you can underline while you are reading the question with a pencil. These are very much useful. See how the answer is given. In the middle of the box, Gandhi Vidyalaya Rewa, as mentioned in the question. Notice in capital letter. See the format of date. It is written 1 April 2020. Here I want to suggest you, while you are writing date in any type of writing section, maybe letter writing, maybe application writing, maybe notice writing, just remember to write down name of the month. Name of the month means April, I have clearly mentioned. If you are going to write 1-4 in place of April, that can be a wrong formatting as per the CBSE guidelines. Next one is catchy heading for lost and found. These headings can be catchy, like lost 3 times with proper space. Then I have taken the second one, body language, which was discussed in formatting. all the students are here, I inform that now you have to write, I have lost. What you have lost? A bottle water. I have lost my bottle place in our school premises. These all things are mentioned in the question itself. Then in extra you can mention its color and company also. So here is a very simple language. Its color is red and company is Milton. Then whosoever, remember this word whosoever, you have to write all together. Whosoever finds it, please return to the undersigned. Undersigned means the person who is going to sign this particular notice. Next, as it is asked by the question, I promise him or her a bar of chocolate. This is a small promise given by you if the finder is coming to return your bottle water. In last, you can mention Nikita or Niket whatsoever. Class, as the designation is not given, if you want you can sign it here. Next one example is of form notice. It is also same like the earlier one. I have changed the name. You are Avni or Avinash, a student of Kendriya Vidyalaya Satna. Write a notice for your school notice board as you found a geometry box in your school premises during lunchtime. Once again, while you are going through the question, underline a few things. Avinash or Avani, Kendriya Vidyalaya Satna, what you have to write, found a notice, when you got that geometry box in lunchtime. These three or four things are very much important. If you are doing so, your half work is done and you can be able to write good notice and very less time. See the example. I have mentioned the name of school, Kendriya Vidyalaya Satna. Once again, notice in capital letter. Once again, date. While you are writing date, you have to remember that no need to mention that date word date. Sometimes we are writing date, then 1st April 2020. It's not needed. Directly you can mention the date without writing date word. As in the earlier notice I told you, found. Here you can mention these catchy heading can be used three times in the notice writing of loss and found only. In all other type of notices, no need to mention that particular heading three times. Now, this time I have used the first one line as a body. This is to inform to all the students that I, what you found? Found a geometry box. Our school, mention our school. Generally students are writing your school, it's wrong. Mention our school, premises during lunchtime. Once again, whosoever is the owner of this, please contact to the undersigned with its detail. There is only one difference while you are writing loss and found notice is that while you are writing loss notice, you have to write details of the particular thing that you have lost. But while you are writing found notice, remember, no need to write any type of details of that particular object. Why it is so? As any person can come and claim that particular object from you. So here you have to hide the detail while you are writing found notice. then last name, you can choose any one name, and then class, once again des in place of the designation, as the designation is not mentioned in the question. If you want, you can sign also. So here is the example of found notice. Lost notice and found notices are useful up to the standard of class 7th only. Example number 3, that is a notice of celebration. You are Ramesh, Rashmi, cultural secretary of Gyan Ganga Public School, Raipur. Write a notice for your school notice board to inform the students about the celebration of annual function in your school. Write all the necessary details. The same practice we will do once again. What are the things important here? Ramesh and Rashmi, cultural secretary. Here the designation is given, cultural secretary. Which school? Gyan Ganga Public School. What you have to do? You have to write notice for what? Celebration of annual function. So these are the few important points which you have underlined. These will be very much useful while you are compiling the notice. See, in the box in the middle I have mentioned Gyan Ganga Public School Raipur. While you are writing the name of the institute, remember first letter of each word start with capital letter, like G of Gyan, G of Ganga, P of Public, S of School, R of Raipur. Again notice in capital letter. Again the date is mentioned in lap margin. Heading annual function, which was mentioned in question itself. This time I use second one body of the notice, and it goes like this. All the students are hereby informed that our school is going to celebrate its annual function. Now the date you have to mention, that is 28th of April 2020. Just one thing I want to make it clear. See, this is 28 and this is first. So clear cut gap should be mentioned between these 2 days. Suppose you are writing a notice on first, proper space or proper time should be given to the student to think for his or her participation. Like you can't mention 27 here and 28 here. Why? Because the students will have only, or the participants will have only 1 day to think and assure their participation. Next one is, what do you want from there? All are requested to participate in various cultural activity. Which type of cultural activities are going to held? Dance, drama, singing, etc. I am not mentioning so many activities. Why? Because it will increase the word limit and we will go beyond 50 words. So you can mention 2 or 3 or mention ATC. Last one, assure your participation before 5th of April 2020. While you are writing any event or celebration notice, one deadline should be given on or before that participant may come and contact you and give their name and get assurance. That is very much necessary. That is not included in lost notice and found notice. Last, you can use any name, two names were given. Here I am using Ramesh. Here the designation is clearly mentioned in the question itself, that was cultural secretary. Okay, and if you want, you can sign it like this. So in this manner, this is a notice of any celebration. Now once again I want to show you the slide or recapitulate the things which are very much important, that key points for writing notice, that are word limit, relevance, formatting, especially with the date, heading, institute name and SND format, use of IV, box and fresh face while you are writing any notice during the examination. And these six things: what, who, where, when, what to do and who. This exercise must be done by you while you are doing or reading the question itself. So here is all about the notice. I think you are able to understand it well, and I hope that next time whenever you are going to appear in any examination, you will follow me and surely write a good notice, and surely you will get good marks. Nowadays full out of full marks are also being given by the teacher, but the condition is only that you have to write it clearly. You have to follow all the rules and regulations while you are writing any notice. Total marks may be differ, it may be of 4 marks, sometime it may be of 5 marks. So it doesn't matter, marking is not a necessary thing for you. I hope you will follow my instruction and do it in better manner. Thank you.